again. Let's try and try again. Let's see if we can get something better than the previous run. I've loaded up some old splits, or I've edited the splits since it's just loaded up some of the old ones from my PB. So let's go and reset. Ooh. Volume is a bit low then. Friends! Okay, we're fine. And it's a fiercely thickening plot. Off we go. Flush up this. Yeah. We've got the light bulb. Yeah, give me a max. Good. We're skipping that part so that I can use it slightly quicker when I go downstairs. Perfect. That will save me some time. Perfect. Hold on a second. I press the button to make the splits go, and the splits don't go. Fantastic. So what's happened this time around? Do I have to start Razor's synapse again? I mean, that's just ruined a perfectly good start to a run. That was a great start. I got things sorted out. Okay. Right, let's try this again with my macro keys now working and allowing me to actually start the game splits, honestly. Here we go again. And we skip through this. Fiercely thickening plot is the last line, and go. Yay, I've got some things now. Good. Right. Got the flashlight. We go over here. Use the use command. It'll give us some walk as well. Max is in a good place this time round. Get him and walk. And walk. Skip, skip.
And here's one for your old man.
Object. And we turn him inside out. Nice. Ah, that's a split. Yay! Save time! Nice. Great coffee, though. Hello, everyone who likes tea and/or coffee. Here we go. Snookies. We'll see what happens here. Come on, Max.
I gotta go to the bathroom.
Thank you.
Hey, my little butt there.
That was not great. Okay, that was actually quite fast. That's not bad. Nice. Okay, plus 1.1. That is not bad. That was probably because I had to take my hands off the keyboard and go to my split control. So that's not too bad. Ah, bad RNG. He tells us to stop, and then we give him the document again anyway. That's fine. Okay, cannibals can be dangerous to your health, was the advice we were given there. So now we swap over to the escape key because half of this is all skippable animation. Right, so now we walk over here and pick this up, and then we pick this up, and then we walk over here, and then we go to Whack-A-Rat. Now, last time we got a run, I got 40 out of 40. Can I do it again? Twice in a row? I had to think about that one. Twice in a row. Oopsie. Here we go. Let's get a good pattern. One, two. I've missed one. Never mind. 39 is still a good score. Aiming for plus 37. Yeah, feeling it. Ah, oopsie. These rats are getting pummeled. 9 to go. Two, 3 to go. Last one. Got him. 38. I'm happy with that one. That's a split. That was a bad split, because I should have got that one easier. Earlier, even.
I want something.
Good-o.
It fits perfectly.
Nice.
Hey, me and my pet.
And we've ridden the ride. That was easy.
Me too. Maybe later. Hey, what a-
And he gives us a slip to go to Lost and Found. Now, we walk out the back. Yeah, the next split is called Let's Give Him a Big Hand. I will explain why when I get to that split. Cool. Now we've got World of Fish, that's fine. And then we go into the background. Why did I come this way again? I've made a mistake here. Never mind, it's a short one. It only takes a few seconds to correct. Oh, it would do if the scene transition worked properly. We're on a ride, the Tunnel of Love. Yippee. This one we do have to go to our inventory, but it doesn't matter too much. Because we need the flashlight. And we can use Max. You can't skip the animation for this one as well, because if you skip the animation, it will actually take you to the end of the ride, and you'll miss the junction box here, which you need to soak with Max's wet body. Chill, dude. That's a lot of lip movement for just, you know? You know? Okay. And we skip on. Okay, and now we use this. Yep. Hey, watch this. Get away from the axe. Why?
Check.
And now we walk through the door. This. And we talk to Doug. He shushed us. How rude. We skip several hours later. We condense it to just a couple of seconds. That's quite good going. Time save. Massive time save. And give us the ball of twine. And candy. He gives us the key.
Keep it short, kid.
Heck of a story, ain't it? We never saw what that story was, and we never cared. So now we go back over this way, to the back of the fair. And luckily, we still have this object equipped, so we can open this door.
Hey, watch.
And whip. rubbish.
Hey, there's a neat costume in here.
And it appears on the map. We walk out. And now we're done. No. We want to walk out. No. Why did I suddenly select my cache? Yeah, we do want to walk out the back there. Because we are leaving the carnival. Now, let's give him a big hand. This is a reminder to me, from me. Firstly, I get to split when I leave. But it is a reminder to me to visit Snuckies. So I can get the hand out of the jar we picked up at the beginning of the game. There's a jar. We give it to him. The split for this will be when I use the car. It should be when I use the car for most things. Good. And then we go to the world of fish. And we pick up the bucket. And I have to take my hand off my mouse because I will be using escape and full stop for this. Then we go back. And that's that split. Very short split, that one. But it means that I definitely get the hand properly. Because now I can save time here. Picking up this. Going to the inventory and using it on the hand immediately. And then going straight over here. It does save time in the long run. Even though I have to go back into my inventory to get the bucket of fish out of my inventory. So just skip the text here. The split for feeding the gators is after I get the correct lineup for the last gator. Bonk. We can still afford to save time here. I've got three rainbow splits. Two of them only count, but the third one, but let's give them a hand. That's a new split, so I'm happy with that one. I gave it lull. Just because. I made it funny. Right, so we take the bucket of fish and we replace it for the bucket of golf balls, which we'll never see again in this run. And then we pick up a golf club and let's play golf with fish. Right, first one we want is about here, I believe. If this is correct, this will line up for the one at the back as well. Hopefully I can get this in one go. I've had three runs of this now. Oh, that was good. So let's try this again. Again, this animation can't be cancelled. It's very slow, and the gator animation is very slow as well. Because they have to go in the water twice. I don't know if that's a correct setup, so I'm going to take that swing again. It's not going to waste me too much time, I don't think. According to my splits, I've probably done this in one go, so I'm now behind by a tiny bit. That's good. So now we want this one. Hopefully this works, and then the last one is in the correct place as well. It turns out they're actually lined up, but one nearest Nessie is already in the correct spot. Flag?
I'm scared, Sam.
You'll be fine, Max. So it's the second one and the one at the very back, and then the first one and the one just in front of him, number four. They take the same pattern, but the one in the middle, the third one, he's in the perfect spot. Just like that. That's a good split. Yes, we did. So now, we're done with golf forever. Again, I don't think I can skip this animation. Okay, we skip that conversation. That's good. We can skip all that as well. That goes in there. Use this. Pick this up. And we get Mystery Vortex. like this. Cool. And we leave. And we go to Spin Tag. Now, Spin Tag is the diner on top of the largest ball of twine on Earth. So we go to Ball of Twine next. Cool. Again, we ignore the museum. We just go straight to the cable car. I don't understand how I'm losing time just yet, so must have done something really well. I did have Arby's RNG. But I don't think that plays into it, because that was still quite fast. I only lost a second there. I don't understand how I lost... Oh, it's probably because I created the new split, so the plus 47 and the plus 31 sort of cancelled each other out. So we skip this animation of them seeing the man with the giant knife. Can't skip the rest of the animation. Can skip the rest of the talking they do. And we go inside. And we want to talk to the gentleman bending stuff. What are you doing?
What you doing?
And we want one.
Let me make
one for you. So this is fine. We can still save time here. And watch those splits carefully. It's all yours. And there we leave him. To get out, you actually have to use the elevator, not walk into it. And the cable car you can use or walk. We will choose to use because we already have that action enabled. Split for Spin Tag is when I do the use icon on the car, so I can still save time. And get this first time. Yeah! Still save time. Right, now we go to Rip Tag, which is my favourite split of all. We go over here, and we use our recently acquired object. No, we don't give it to the fisherman. We give it to the porcelain fish on the side here, and here we go. Good-o. That did the trick. Now we get in. Come on. Then we use Max, and that's the split for that one. We're saving time now, boys. We skip the animation for this, and okay, now we're back at Ball of Twine. Rope and Ring is the next one. Rope is easy enough. I already have Max equipped as my object, so I just need to use him on the Ball of Twine. Book. There's a hollow sound as it just bounces off the ball. That sound is always delightful as well. We're doing okay so far. Down 5 seconds. I'm sure we can save more time. Hopefully, we've got through most of the RNG part of this. Animation, which can't really skip through, but we get 91 yards of the ball of twine, so now we skip through the rest of the text of this scene, and we jump ourselves off the ball, and we have our landing broken. Where's our car? There's our car. We got our car back. That was easy enough. There we go inside. Now. Inventory use. We use the magnet with this, and we pick it up, and that's a split. I'm going to split now on using the item on the ball of twine, because we all know what happens. We get the ball, we got the ring. That's good. Right, now we go out. And use the car. Next, do RNG. Yep, we're going to Mystery Vortex, and... I was really on point when I named these splits. Mystery Vortex. That pinging sound was the metal plate in Max's head. There are magnets under the ground, of course. So the first thing, red, orange. That seems to be the orange, white. Now last split, that was red, orange, blue. So I know. Yeah. So it seems as though red and orange are frequent flyers when it comes to these splits. So that's good news. Hopefully the door this time round is red and I don't get ruined by doo 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 RNG, because that did kind of screw everything up last time. I did have to pull the magnet and then go through the third door, so that's really slow. Hopefully this doesn't happen this time round. We shall see. This could be amazing. It would be a huge time save if it is actually red. Go in. It doesn't want to go in. That is not correct. Ow. So let's go for orange and hopefully we go through door number two. We can still save time here. That's going to be amazing if I do, because it's going to get close. Right, so now we just want to walk over here. This is interesting. The walk with the fingers walking, the normal walk icon, actually doesn't work. You actually have to pull right over to the edge of the screen where you don't think you can use the walking icon, and it will actually move you over there. It's very weird. I don't understand how they programmed it that way. That seems really counterintuitive. So now let's see if I can go in door number two. Come on, splits. Use the door. I can't tell if that was correct or not because the duck past the window quacked at the same time. Come on, Max, hurry up. Yay, that was correct. Now, if we get OS Frog percent, we could get a really good run here. Something something Bruno. Blah 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 blah. I don't know where he is. Blah blah blah. Get my soul ring for me. Come on, mood ring, mood ring. Cool. We got it. Blah 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 blah. Give me the dust. I'm just ruining the story. Sorry, guys. If you wanted to play this game casually, I recommend you do it. And oh wow, this is really good for us because we're right next to the exit as well. This is really good RNG so far. Okay, let's get out of here. Let's go back to Ball of Twine, and we want to go back up to the diner. Going back up to the diner, we need to fix the motor mechanism on the diner so that we can mount it to the binoculars. And then we want to use the magnifying glass so we can see a long range, because magnifying glass and binoculars obviously work together. Who knew? I didn't. Get in. And we get Max to hurry up. And then we need to find the rock. Now, last time it was on the fifth out of five attempts that I got Frog Rock. That's really not good. So hopefully we get it first time this round. We want to pick up the wires and use the wires here. We electrocute ourselves, as we do. And then we electrocute Max for funsies. Here. Okay. Then we pick up the magnifying lens and use it on here. And then we use this.
It's a rock.
Not the first one.
It's a rock.
That's the second.
It's a rock.
That's the third. Oh dear.
It's a rock.
That's the fourth. We're going five for five. Oops. And we got it. Not great, but I had to go five for five again. That was really not good for me. But whatever. We found it. We still saved time overall. 24 seconds up. That's really good news. So now we just need to come back over here, and I need Sam to not try and go into my inventory when I walk him over to the car again. That's. We only have to come to this place once more, and every time he has difficulties walking over here. Come on. You can do it, Sam. Come on. Yes! Good. Right. So now we've found Frog Rock, we have to go to Frog Rock. As is our tradition. Find a place, go to a place. Now. Right. In our inventory, we want the first Sasquatch here. And we keep spamming this button so that we don't get all the text. Because Max will say the same thing 3 times in a row. So we don't care about that.
Another tuft of Sasquatch here.
Shut up. Thank you. Don't know why it gave me the look icon instead of the place icon, so... That's gross, Sam. Yes, it is. And then we need this. That's number 3. Yes, it is, and this is number 4. Good. And then we wait for the cosmic alignment, the Illuminati hypertag, all the woke emotes, as we call them. Can't skip the animation, can skip the dialogue, which is interesting because I'm fairly sure skipping the dialogue for the Space Mole Man actually doesn't speed the animation along. I'm fairly sure it just skips the text and then does nothing until the animation plays out. And then we get the astrological sign of Bumpersville, the 13th. They thought it was Orichalcos. No. The 13th astrological sign is Bumpersville. So now we go back over to the car and we go to Bumpersville. So we skip the intro. Note of interest, if you use the cache on the wishing well, you get the alternate ending to the game. Anyone who's played this game knows exactly what I'm talking about. Again, if you haven't played this game before, I really urge you to play it. It's a really fun game.
Okay.
So now we want to walk up the truck. Of course, Conroy Bumpers wouldn't be able to climb that by himself without an escalator. Now we pick up the pillow. And we go in here, and we want to pick up the hand, and we want this book. Hey, Max, be useful. Hold this. Got him. Oh, I've incapacitated my buddy. I hope he hasn't got any serious lasting brain damage or anything like that. Oops. And then we get the Jeopardy music. And then we get the animation. This is now several hours later, 15 hours later. He gets to the end of the book, and now he knows how to do robot surgery. And hopefully the robot is nearby. If the robot is nearby, this is great news for us. I don't want to have to go searching the whole house for him. Good. And he was close to his location where he has to go. Here's Leia. Hi, Leia. Bye, Leia. Hi, Brain. This is Pinky and the Brain, and we're good. Let's get ready to roll. Robot will do robot things for us. Perfect. Lee Harvey goes, what the heck? Because he's a yokel, apparently. And then, with him out of the way, we can go to the back room and use the virtual reality equipment. As I mentioned in my last video, the name of this split is VR hasn't really changed that much. You'll see why in a second. Okay. This is virtual reality. It sucks. Don't pull his head off! Don't pull his head off! Okay, now we have the sword. Let's walk over here. Oh god, it's a dragon! Okay. And then we do some kung fu karate style with Max as a sword, and splatterino! Dragon's dead. Let's take this. And we have the key. Where did he pull that from when he was supposed to be in virtual reality? No idea. Does it ever get brought up again? Absolutely not. If you're playing this game casually, they do say that they use the virtual reality for the security measures of the mansion, but they don't explain how or why. And this is never brought up again. Thank you. And his noggin came off for a small amount of time. And now he's gone. And then we use the object on this. And it worked first time this round, instead of Sam deciding to just to walk all over the place for no reason. We can't skip the animation, but we can skip the text. And next split is Chertan. Chertan, they tell us they're going to a tiki bar run by what's the name of the actress? A B movie actress, basically. She's retired. Called Evelyn Morrison. She never appears in any of the other games after this one. Well, she is a great character. Hello, Indiana Jones reference. There's going to be another one coming up as well. So we get the tiki bar on the map now. We can visit there as patrons. Now we go through here, and we want to pick up this. And as soon as this happens, we skip that song because we don't like songs. We don't like animation. We don't want our Disney moments in this game. I'm fairly sure, even though LucasArts are now owned by Disney, in the past they would have sued us. So that would create a temporal paradox. Let's just go over here. And Tiki Bar. Welcome the podiatrally gifted. That's the word I was looking for in my previous run. Podiatrally gifted. What we can do here is we can give this poor chappy a rasp because he needs to file his corns because he is so in pain. And he's gratitude. Gratitude. So now he's happy. Are we sorted? Good. Right. I think we're okay.
I'll get back.
And we look at the brochures. And we get two locations. So that's Chertan done. So now we are free to leave this place until later. We used to go. And we go to Dinosaur Land, which is where I was supposed to go to last time. We're at Mount Rushmore. The Dino Bungee Memorial Mountain, I believe it's called. We're in no North Dakota. The bungee's coming out the noses. It gets me every time. It's funny. We are going to go bungee jumping. Because we need tar from the tar pit slide. We don't want to wait in line because that line goes forever. Because the child is actually stuck to the slide. And so he's not going anywhere fast. Ever. I like the prehistoric animals are in there as well. Slowly, yeah. Less said about that, the better. Okay. We use the screen and we get dressed for jumping and all that stuff. And now let's get up here and use the bungee cord. And we'll need my inventory immediately. And here we go. We want to equip the Snooki's Cup with the glass, and we want to pick this out of the inventory and use it on the tar. And that is how you get tar, ladies and gentlemen. You use Jesse James's severed hand on top of a broken golf ball retriever using a giant 20-ounce cup, and apparently that will get you tar. It could only work in the game logic, couldn't it? Honestly. Right, use the elevator again. And we're on good time here. The last thing we need to do for this place, is we need to collect some mammoth fur. We need to collect some mammoth fur and a dinosaur tooth. So we go back to the front part of the entrance. No, use tool. I don't think we talk to a speakerphone. We use it. No, you've gone to the wrong place, Max. What the hell are you doing? Sam, honestly, come on. Right, let's use this. Right. Now we use Max. If you let me, come here.
Hey.
I I'm gonna make some time save here, I believe. This could be big, actually. A big time save. It looks like it's gonna be about a minute or so. We'll see. What we want now is Sam to get a move on. And he goes, wow! Look how embarrassed we can make a mammoth. Ouch, that's a severe baldness. Okay, now we deposit this and we go to our inventory and we want to pick out the twine that we procured later, earlier even. We skip this animation, but it seems like we can't. I'm down to about under a minute now of time save. That's okay. Right, Max, come here, would you? I love the grin that Sam pulls at that moment. And we fling him. This is called the Sammy Shake, for obvious reasons. Hump. And there's the tooth. The whole tooth and nothing but. There's a split. We go to Vegetable Land. I call this the Wix Bee Collection, because of vegetables. funny. I have a really bad sense of humor. We go here. We give the John Muir portrait. Right. Let's leave this place and immediately return to it. And in doing so, that actually gets the trigger. So now, when we talk to this lady and we ask about our gourd, we actually get it. Now we can leave it. And now we walk over here and use the car again. And that is that. We're now going for Arctic Igloo, which is part of the wrapping up of the game now. We need to use some items together. So firstly, we cover the costuming tarp, and then we cover it in mammoth fur. Then, one problem. We don't have a wig. So, return to Bumblesville. And with that Conroy Bumpus eggplant we just picked up, we now go back into the side room of the mansion and shout out to Raiders of the Lost Ark. And we can't skip this, but it's fun to watch. Enjoy. And it's a perfect match. Or is it? My face! And we get promptly kicked out of the house. But that's okay. But now we have the toupee, which we can now attach
Okay, I've attached.
to the suit, and we're on our way back to Tiki Lodge. And while we're in here, do I have an object? No, I didn't select it. Okay. Come on, Max. And we put it on together. This is good, apparently. And that will get us into the big football, because it's a convincing enough costume. So now we go in. And we do that on the way past. Let's just pick this up. We'll be needing it later. And we walk around the back to the back of the kitchen. We pick up the ice pick. That's all we need in here, so let's just leave. We don't need to be in here for anything else. Ah, damn! Conroy and Lee Harvey decide to just turn up. Now he goes back to the van to get a net, I believe it is.
There's something you
should know. I'm not a Bigfoot. Shock, surprise. So, what else can I do from this location? Hey, no fanny business. Max, would
Looks
you
like
do
you're
the
thinking it all
honors?
backwards, boss.
Hey, Max.
Let's put them on ice. You know what killed the dinosaurs? The Ice Age. So that's Arctic Igloo. So now we're just cleaning up the rest of the game. So obviously the icon for that split is Wixweep. I have no shame, honestly. Go inside. Okay. I apologize for absolutely nothing with these splits. I honestly, I don't care. So for cleaning up, we use the cart, and we're going back to Ball of Twine for the last time because we have an appointment which we need to keep. We're going back to the man who made us the left-handed bent spanner, and the I'm fairly sure that's an innuendo somewhere. The reason why we're going is we have an ice pick, which is not well adapted to get this cork out of the bottle. So instead, we're going to see whether you can bend it and turn it into a corkscrew. And go inside. And I go to my inventory and pick up the ice pick. And talk to this guy with the ice pick. And yeah, I didn't get him bending his own tools, so now I have one of these. And I could use it straight on the
That
bottle.
seems to have got split.
And then I just need to pick it up and
That
use it.
seems to.
Yep. And we go straight to using the elevator again. And using the cable car. Things are heating up. 39:42. This could be a good run here. This could definitely be a good run. We'll see. Just need him to get over here and use the cart. Last trip before the end of the game is Mr. Vortex. Just about here on the map. We go inside. We're going all the way back around to the reception again. Through the curtains and use the machine. And we step in. Ding. And I get control of my thing. And we suck the vortex into the cube and put the stopper on it. So it won't escape again. So now we have a miniature handheld vortex. So now we're in the home stretch. Cleaning up, I will split as I press use on the car. So I believe I'm about 17 seconds ahead here. And that's a split. 11. Oh dear. This is getting close now. We go inside. And we go through. Around the front. This is literally a race to the pool now. The case closed. Come on, come on. Gonna move on. Thank you. Literally all we need to do, use four items on the pool. The first one is the snow globe full of the Mystery Vortex power. Second is the dinosaur tooth. Third one is the vegetable of John Muir. And the last one is the pillow, which is full of hair growth tonic. Now, that's the first one. We give it to the chief. The chief is extremely happy with this. I think we're looking at a PB here. This could be good. It all depends on how quickly I can get through this inventory section and how quickly these animations. Again, these animations cannot be cancelled. And we use the dinosaur tooth. We don't need to give it to the chief, we just need to use these on the pool. And that will complete as time will be as soon as I use the fourth and final item on the pool. Next item is the gourd.
Yep.
I can't remember, they look identical, but one is said to be a gourd and the other's meant to be an eggplant. I believe this is a gourd. I mean, I'm not one with the whole vegetable similarities thing. That's the third totem, the last one. And the last one is... Where is it? The, oh dear. Oh, that cost me time. And time!
Hey,
and that is a personal best!
Something that might tie into your totem poles. Yeah? What is it?
43:21. And that is a solid 30 seconds or so on my best time. I think you can see it, or I can see it on my screen. The amount of rainbow splits in the last 12. In the last 12? In the last 7.
Very resourceful. We just like...
So, we skip to the ending. Basically, they need a Bigfoot to sacrifice to the Great Soup. And it seems as though they have one on ice. Eh! Bigfoot substitute. Clapper. And what happens next? Well, the mystical powers of North America and Bigfoot Enterprises, we present to you the mighty Redwood Tree. Several hundred thousand of them. Remember, it all starts near the West Coast. San Francisco, ruined. Washington, Vancouver. You know, most of North America and Canada. A ball of twine is affected. I don't know what to tell you. We covered the entirety of the Northwest and the West Coast, and a little bit of Canada, too.
We want to be in a place where we can sort of blend in, live our lives, maybe even raise a family.
Ew.
Goodbye, everyone.
Goodbye, you nutsy primitive man beast, you. You boys should be proud of what you've helped us achieve here today. You mean the wholesale destruction of the symbols of modern civilization in the western United States? You bet we are.
What a prize?
Well, oh, why not? This medallion has been a part of my family for untold generations. Wear it in good health. Thanks, Chief. Max loves cheap sentiment.
Cheap chocolate sentiment?
Mm-hmm. Foil-covered chocolatey goodness. What's wrong, Sam?
I don't think the wizard has anything in that bag for me. Well, I could give you my ritual headdress that I bought at Snucky's last week.
Oh dear.
I appreciate the gesture, but I've already got a hat.
Well, that's fine too. Farewell, Sam and Max. Remember, though the night be dark, the dawn yet shall awaken and annoy you. Have a nice day.
Have a nice day.
I'll miss that old rascal.
I'll miss the way he smelled like a bag full of damp hamster shavings.
Ugh.
Just like Grandpa. Hey, we forgot to get paid.
Don't worry, little buddy. I've got it all covered.
I hope you're happy. With those idiots on the case, we'll probably never see Bruno again.
Oh, lighten up, Burl. Hey, they're back.
Did you find Bruno?
Of course.
Bruno!
How can we ever repay you? The boy
And, ladies and gentlemen, that is the end of the game. And I am so happy. 43-21. Firstly, it's a PB. Secondly, it beats my other time, which I didn't have a recording of. So, currently at this point, ladies and gentlemen, 43-21-37 is the second world record for Scum VM any percent. That is the second record. The first entry in this category was actually posted to speedrun.com 11 years ago. The current record is a monumental 36:35. That is almost 7 minutes down. I don't actually know how he got it that low, other than I've watched the video, and that time is correct. I will have to actually swat up and figure out how he actually got that time, but I am very happy to announce 43:21 is a second world record, second place. Do I want to do another run? Not tonight. This will be uploaded to YouTube. I will also upload the video I had before, and I will upload these to YouTube. I will upload my splits as well. If you want to enjoy the crazy naming scheme that I have for these, including such classics as The Hole Tooth, Wix B Collection, VR Hasn't Changed Much, Do 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 RNG. Yeah. I picked a lot of emotes from a lot of friends that I know and a lot of people that I follow and subscribe to. And yeah. It just turned out that there was pretty much an emote for every occasion for every single split of this run. I'm very happy with everything so far. So, yeah, I'm going to end it there for this video. Thank you very much. If you've watched it this far, this recording is just shy of an hour. It's 52 minutes so far. And you've been here watching 9 minutes of me waffling and me really screwing up with Scum because my keyboard did not register me start the split. But with that being said, 43:21. Very happy with that as a PB. That's all I've got to say, really. Second world record. Second record. Thanks for watching. If you've watched this, if you enjoyed it, let me know. If you want to play this game, please pick up this game. It's available on Good Old Games, as well as you can actually find the ROM and download it and use it with Scum VM, Scum Virtual Machine. There are a lot of other games for Scum VM as well, including most of the old versions of the Monkey Island franchise. So I would urge you to play those games. I would urge you to play this game. And yeah, that's all I've got to say. Thanks, guys. See you later.